to the top.
Well, Molly and Norman, welcome to Look North. It's great to have you here in the studio.
Hi, Sharks.
You were nearly away there, weren't you, in that interview? You were nearly away. You nearly had me in tears.
I was. It was such an emotional time.
What is it about skiing? What is it, you two? Come on.
It's a real challenge. It's a challenge to your patience, to your physical ability, and the fact that you must not give in, because you're not going to get any further. If you do give in, obviously, that's a given. But it gives you this tenacity and the strength that you can carry it into different walks of life.
Well, you could have given in a long time ago when the Sheffield Ski Village sadly closed, but you carried on, and as we heard there, you do the 85-mile round trip to take young people to Castleford to learn there. Why did you carry on, Molly, when, you know, you could have said, this has got too much, now it needs to stop?
Mainly because the young people and the parents just wanted to. I mean, we carried on at Sheffield for as long as we could, i.e. once the fire came, we were still going, and we were even walking up the slope when the lift went and skiing down. Mm. But then, sadly, at the last fire, that was it. And we had one of our ex-sharks was the manager of Manchester, Chill Factor then, and we were in no man's land, and he said, oh, come up to Manchester, we'd love to have you. The first time you come, you can have it for free, and then we'll negotiate something. This particular ex-manager of Chill at Sheffield is now the manager of Dubai, which we're very proud of. So we went there, but it was a long journey, early in the morning, and it didn't work for some of them. So we went to various other dry slopes around the country.
And then you've ended up Castleford, which is amazing. Sorry to interrupt you there, because I know obviously what's been great for you is that, you know, Olympians have been made, haven't they? So we've got a little surprise for you, a little message. I want you to pay attention here and just listen to this little message from Molly and Katie Summerhayes.
Molly and Norman, you have always been brilliant to us and really inspired us.
I'm glad to say that you've not only just been shortlisted for the BBC Yorkshire Unsung Sporting Hero Award, but
you've won it!
Woo! Yeah. You're joking!
It's true.
Congratulations.
You can't do that.
We caught you here, sorry, under false pretences. You have actually won the Yorkshire Unsung Sporting Heroes.
So congratulations, take it, yeah.
How does it feel?
Well, it feels a bit heavy. Well, you've shocked us. You really have shocked us. And it was Katie and Molly that did it for themselves to get to the Olympics. We just started them and encouraged them, I hope. And it was the other coaches that really got them there.
Can I just say that, you know, you can't do this on your own. It takes a chairman, a committee and instructors that are fanatical like we are, and you can't do it on your own. And
you're both very modest, but how does it feel to see people like that reach the Olympics?
It's fantastic.
So it's.
But again, you can only take them so far, and the whole point of being a good club and a good coach is that you know when to pass athletes like
Absolutely.
These on to get them to a higher stage.
Congratulations to you both. Yeah. We're running out of time, but we just want to say well done. And you will get to go to the BBC Sports Personality Awards in Birmingham in December, which is great. And of course, you're in the national shortlist now, aren't you? Which is fantastic. Okay. So well done.
No, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
And well done for all
Thanks,
your
Thanks, guys. Thank you, Katie. Thanks, Molly.